It's time to get a little deeper. I assume that you already know all the basics about track days and how to prepare yourself and your car for them. The next thing on our list, as you've probably already thought, is to touch on some basic driving techniques, the correct position behind the steering wheel and how to achieve it, some tips and tricks that will drastically help you while driving, general car behavior, and how to get out of any situation that the car may throw you, and so on. So, without further ado, in order to have the best possible control and feel of your car, one of the most important things is how you sit and interact with the vehicle. Many of you may not know this, but you actually feel and perceive everything that the vehicle does a lot better through the seat than with your hands through the steering wheel and feet through the pedals. That's why the right seating position is so important while driving and is something that will let you have a way better and direct feel and also get more information about what the car is doing. This way, you will be able to control it and react accordingly, more precisely, and faster. That is something that will help you not only on the track, but in your everyday driving as well. So we suggest trying to adjust your seat and steering wheel the way we are going to show you, not only when going to the circuit, it can actually help you get out of a situation on the road that can otherwise turn into an accident. Now, let me show you what exactly we mean by the term correct driving position. The first thing you will want to adjust is your seat. On many of the modern cars, there are a lot of positions and parts of the seat that can be regulated and adjusted, but for the sake of the video, we will divide it into just four main parts of seating adjustments. Those adjustments will be the height, moving the seat up and down, the reach, moving the seat forwards and backwards, the angle of the backrest, and the height of the headrest. One important consideration here is that the order in which you adjust every one of those components is not random, but in exactly this order. You may be wondering why. Because by regulating the height of the seat in most cases, it also goes a little bit forward and backward as well. So you will see how, if you've adjusted your reach first and start adjusting the height after, that you may find yourself in a different reach position than the one you've just set. As we've already clarified, we're starting with the height. Here there is only one rule. If I can express myself this way, the seat must be in its lowest position, meaning as close to the ground as possible. When you sit as low as possible in the car, you are actually lowering its center of gravity and making it more balanced and stable. The second, and in reality the more important one, is that by sitting as close to the ground as possible, you are more connected to the car. It will give you better feedback, and you are going to feel every change in direction a lot faster. The only time that the height of the seat can go a little higher than its lowest position is if it actually obstructs your vision in some way. After you've adjusted the height, it's time for the forward-backward position. You just need to have a good reach to your pedals. A rule of thumb that you can use is that when you fully press your clutch, there must be a little angle left in your knee. The next thing is the backrest. Here, the thing that mainly guides the right position is the same as the height adjustment department. Your backrest must be as straight as possible, close to 90 degrees. That will once again give you the best feedback and feel from the car, and you'll be able to react a lot faster in most situations. And the last thing left is something that's not concerning the seating position itself directly, but it's actually more of a safety measure, the headrest. A thing that is often overlooked, but that is there to support your neck and prevent a whiplash in the case of an accident. So don't forget to adjust it as well. It must be at the level of the back of your head. One bonus tip we want to give you here that's not directly related with the seat is that if the handrest of your car's central console can go up, put it up. It will free a lot of space for your hands that you'll see will be a big advantage when you're on the track. After adjusting the seat, it's time to adjust the steering wheel as well. On most cars, there are two axes on which you can do that, height and reach. Rules that you can follow in order to achieve optimal steering wheel position are the following. The height must be adjusted so that when you hold the wheel in the correct position, 3 and 9 o'clock, your hands must be almost at the level of your shoulders. As for the reach adjustment, you should be trying to achieve something close to a 90-degree bend in your elbows. An easy way to check it is by extending and putting your hands on top of the steering wheel. Your wrist must be exactly on the level of the wheel. That will almost certainly give you those 90 degrees when you put down your hands on the wheel. Of course, after everything said, don't forget that no matter what, the first and most important thing is for you to be comfortable inside your car in order to be fast. So feel free to change a little bit those adjustments here and there, but bear in mind that we strongly suggest you stick to them as close as possible.